Get inside, get what we need.
And this was this week's Closet Classic.
How you doing? I'm Rick Henegan, and I'm here again with all the fine people that helped me out here at BCAT Studios to introduce to you Mike Maloney. Mike is a musician and singer, and Mike is here today from Medford?
Medford, Mass.
Okay. And my mom found Mike at a church gathering, and that's how Mike got here. And so it could be the beginning of a world-famous career. So let's find out. So tell us about yourself.
Michael Maloney from Medford, Massachusetts. So it's a lot of M's for you. I'm 20. I'm technically a sophomore at UMass Boston, though it'll probably take a few more than 4 years. I'm doing a double major in music and health science. I've been doing the piano since I was about 8, and then joined the church choir when I was about 9 or 10, and my life has been ruined ever since. Sort of joke. Okay, we need a drum. We need a drum player.
Okay, and you're hired. So is your mom proud of you? Would you say that, Mike?
Yeah, that's an understatement to the max. She's proud of her children. We have an older sister as well. And
I've talked to your mom since calling you than I have my own.
Yeah, she can.
She's a promoter.
Yeah, she's a talker, and she'll tell you everything about me and what's going on. And
so, what's her favorite music that you play?
Oh, I don't know. I do. I work at a few local churches in Wakefield and Medford, so she does like when I do, especially "Gentle Woman" about Mary. She likes that one when I do religious songs, but she does like, I do the oldies and the goodies. I love the Beatles, Paul McCartney, especially his solo career. So she'll like when I do, John Denver as well. I'll hopefully to do John Denver tune in a while.
So what things did she tell me about you?
What didn't she tell? I don't know.
Well, there's no bearskin picture, I'm told, but other than that, she pretty much filled me in completely. So I understand that you have an interesting job.
I'll have a job coming up over the summer.
Employment's real big on the show.
Yeah, employment's very good, especially during these times. Over the last few years, I've had the opportunity to be a teacher assistant for a few workshops at the Wang Theater in town in Boston. It's now called City Center, but it was called the Wang Theater when I began.
And so what kind of educational experience is it? Is it for new musicians or musician groups?
Yeah, it's for students and just to get them involved in music. It's their outreach program is called the Susskind Young Arts Foundation, and every few months or so they have a different thing with young kids. From ages from 8 and upwards, I think. And this summer specifically, it's called the Sing Out Loud Workshop, Celebrate Musical Theater. And I did it last year, and I guess they liked what I did, and they asked me back for the summer. And I'm going to be working with about 30 high school students to put on about a 20-minute show. It's going to be in the lobby at the Wang Theater, and so we'll be teaching them music, and there'll be a choreographer, so we're going to do a little.
So they get a whole theaterized
song
experience.
And dance for
Pitter and a Patter.
Yeah, a bit of that and a bit of this, and some of them might have a lot of music experience. But some others might have more theater experience. So it's a bit of both worlds.
So I understand that you write your own music as well.
Yeah, I in addition to the piano, I play the guitar. I dabble on the drums and bass guitar. I picked up the ukulele about a few months ago, and I have written.
So are you tiptoeing?
I tiptoed through the tulips, as they say.
Guy made $1 million playing
that
thing.
He made $1 billion and was married on Johnny Carson, that guy. Yeah. Good for him. But I do write songs for about 6 or 7 years now I've been writing.
And so have songs. You ever won an award or a gift or?
Well, I told you one thing before.
Uh-huh, your mom told me, yeah.
I'm sure your mom filled you in.
Yes, she did.
I'm sure she
right
did.
Right down to who you parodized.
She probably told you my DNA type as well, everything else. But it's, I entered a contest 3 years ago in 2010. The radio station 105.7 WROR has a DJ, Tom Doyle. Mm-hmm. And one of the bits that he does is he'll do a parody of a famous song like, "These boots were made in Brockton." Mm-hmm. Or, you know, "Come to Medford right now." And they're having a contest. And a friend told me, "Hey, Mike, they're having a contest, and it's due, submission is due in 1 week." Of course, said to give me 1 week. And so on the Friday night, she told me, and I tried to think of, you have to do a parody about your own town. Mm-hmm. And although they already had a song about Medford, I thought, Medford's so cool, we should have another song.
Uh-huh.
And since I love the Beatles, I sort of thought of some Beatles songs, and I decided on The Long and Winding Road.
Uh-huh.
And so I wrote The Long and Winding Road to Medford,
mm-hmm.
and I include how Michael Bloomberg is from Medford, Maria Menounos, she's a host of one of those celebrity gossip shows.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and fun facts of how our football team is really bad and how we're always beaten by Malden.
It's terrible.
Hopefully I'm not going to get beaten up, but I haven't been beaten up so far, which is good about that, by the football players. They're like, "Maloney, we're going to get you, but you're just too cool. We're going to leave you alone. We're going to leave you alone." But so I entered that, mm-hmm. and the next week there was 100 submissions total, and they narrowed it down to 10, and I made it to the 10, and I just, with the support of Medford and everyone I know, everyone voted online, and they announced that they decided mine was the most hilarious tune, I guess, and I won a nice check for $5,000.
So there's money in parodies, huh?
Yeah, and Weird Al. Weird Al is, you know, look at Weird Al. He's rolling in it. But yeah, so that was fun.
So what do you consider your strength, the singing or the writing?
I don't know. I enjoy writing.
Which is paid more?
I'd say singing for now.
Oh, okay.
Nobody, I think I've probably only made $3 or $4 off of my own songs from a few people.
Well,
say.
$3 or $4 plus $5,000.
Plus $5,000. That's true. That's true. But I do play at nursing homes. The How I Met Your Mother at the St. Patrick's luncheon a few weeks ago. And I also do the, I played the Wakefield Care and Rehab Center in Wakefield, and I've played at the Dexter House in Malden and the Arnold House in Stoneham and the Bayless House in Boston.
So what's your favorite music? I mean, I know that a little bit you've talked about what you most often play, which you mentioned you have to play for the audience. What do you listen to?
Yes, I listen to mostly oldies, mostly. All the Beatles, all of their albums. Paul McCartney has about 22 albums, and I probably have about 18 of them, which I'm proud to say. But I listen to a lot of the Beatles, and Beach Boys, Billy Joel, and Elton John. But for music today, I do listen to Coldplay. Big fan of Coldplay, mm-hmm. big hit. Viva La Vida a few months ago. Mm-hmm. There's a good band called Keen. They're a trio of a pianist, a singer, and a drummer. Mm-hmm. So they're pretty nice too. And there's a band from Scotland called Travis, mm-hmm, that I like. I don't know if you might not know them.
Yeah, no, I've heard of them.
Look them up.
Yeah.
Simon and Garfunkel.
Who?
Can't go wrong. Simon and they're a new group coming out.
Oh, okay. Okay. So, do you want to try playing some?
If you'd allow me to.
Yeah, well, we'll allow you to. Because we've got to fill the time somehow.
Okay, that's good.
I mean, you haven't got much life. You're only 20, so.
Yeah, I'm just out from the cradle.
Yeah.
Well, okay, how about What a Wonderful World?
Okay.
It's made famous by Louis Armstrong.
Is that what my mom asked for?
No, I just thought it's a great song.
And, that sounds good.
You know. If you see Good Morning Vietnam with Robin Williams, when you hear the song, you want to cry.
Yeah.
You want to cry. So hopefully you won't want to cry for the wrong reasons, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. So thank you.
Okay. That was really good. So how did you really get started? I mean, like, you have a song repertoire now, right? So
I do.
How do you develop that? I mean, how do you choose the songs that are going to be in your sort of catalog?
At first I probably chose the really wrong songs to play for an older audience.
Mm-hmm.
I only, you know...
They didn't like you too?
They didn't like you too. No, they didn't like... where the streets have no name.
Yeah. They didn't like that?
No.
Yeah.
But I didn't really know
Sunday,
what
Bloody
to play.
Sunday?
Sunday Bloody Sunday. They stormed out. No, I never played that song. But I wouldn't really know what to play. And so over the years, I would get recommendations and requests, mm-hmm. and I would just write them down and look them up.
Mm-hmm.
And then so when I go back to a nursing home the next time, I'm going to say, oh, I got the song that someone requested last time. And
mm-hmm.
over the years, it adds up, and I have about an hour and a half to 2 hours worth of material that they really like, songs from the 30s to the 50s that the audience that they know. I don't
mm-hmm.
I don't really know them, but because of the requests over the years, I looked them up and
mm-hmm.
play what they want to hear.
Right. So have you found that there's been any artists that you did begin to enjoy because of their, like when you used to listen to interviews of the Beatles, they would say, well, Frank Sinatra was someone that they sort of came to like because they met him and they knew him and, they liked the beat and stuff. And you could hear some of their music that would parallel some of what he was singing and doing. Did you find that, like, with your own writing?
I got a lot of requests for Elvis,
mm-hmm.
And a few for John Denver. I know it's a really sneaky segue into a song that I was going to do
mm-hmm.
in a few minutes, but and my dad grew up with John Denver, and so he listened to a lot of, they got him a country boy. Mm-hmm. My dad likes that type of music, where you're like...
Knee-slapping.
Knee-slapping music, and... that's not the very best first song to know about John Denver, but people requested Country Roads and,
mm-hmm.
and Annie Song. And so over the years, my dad would have records, and so he'd be like, I check this one out. And
mm-hmm.
so over the years, I do like, I've grown a fond of John Denver's music and his acoustic abilities. And he's even done a few covers of... I found out a few covers of the Beatles.
Mm-hmm.
He has a cover of Mother Nature's Son by the Beatles, which mm-hmm. which is really good. And Let It Be, too. He did Let It Be.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Learn something new every day.
That's right. YouTube.
Yeah. Oh, is that where you learned it? YouTube is what I know. But so why don't you try the next song and go from there?
Sure. Actually, I have a fun story about the song.
Okay.
Because I was watching a show once about John Denver's life,
mm-hmm.
and he really liked to go skiing, and one day he was up in the mountains skiing, and
mm-hmm.
he really liked nature, as you could tell, and
mm-hmm.
As he was coming down, he just was soaking in all the snow,
mm-hmm.
and the snow on the trees, and birds, and, I don't know, deer walking by, who knows what he saw, and he was so enlivened by the experience that all he could think of was his wife, Annie.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time he reached the bottom of the hill, he had already written Annie's song.
Oh, wow.
And it's come to be, I think, one of the top choices for weddings. And it's a great melody.
So do you do weddings?
I've done a few weddings.
Uh-huh.
I actually just had one last week, which is interesting. It's a blast to play, Canon and D.
Uh-huh.
And all the, when the bride's walking down, you're like, wow, this is...
Right.
Because I watch a lot of movies.
So if called, you do weddings.
So if called, I do weddings. And on a more mellow note, I have played for funerals as well. And just typical masses.
And what would be the favorite? Danny Boy or?
Yeah, Danny Boy's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a big one. On Eagle's Wings.
Are the Saints go marching afraid. In?
No.
No, not yet?
No.
Not so much.
At nursing homes, I do. When the Saints go marching into,
Yeah.
It wakes them up. It gets them going. If it's a rainy afternoon, you need to...
Liven things up.
You need to get the electricity in the air.
Why not U2's Bloody Sunday?
Bloody Sunday, Sunday, Bloody Sunday,
That wakes people up. Okay. Well, let's
hear it. So, yeah, John Denver's Annie song.
Okay. So, let's hear John Denver's Annie song.
Okay. Hope you enjoy.
With Michael Maloney. His mom says he's good.
Apparently so.
Annie senses, like a night in the forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses. Again, come let me love you, let me give my life to you, let me drown in your laughter, let me die in your arms, let me lay down beside you, let me always be with you. Love me again. Let me always be with you. Let me love you, come love me again. You fill up my senses, like a night in the forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me again.
That was very good.
Thank you. Really, oh, good. Sorry. I'm in your shot.
Oh, no, there's no shot. At least not that I've known of yet. So what are your future plans? I mean, what was your hope for? You did mention your UMI, which is the best thing in Massachusetts. And as I mentioned, there's only maroon and gray, and there's no other colors.
Well, mine are blue and white.
What?
At UMass Boston.
Yeah, but UMass Amherst is a flagship.
Well, we're the beacons, and we help
You're
guide
on an
the
island that's sinking.
We help the boats
find their way in the fog. So, what do you do when you're out there on the island? They used to have a prison island too.
Oh, I don't know about that, it's pretty nice. It's a good location. There's a nice breeze on a nice day.
Uh-huh.
But when the weather's a bit rainy.
You probably tour the Kennedy Museum every chance you can get, right?
A few times, not a lot. Oh. Once you're, it's right there, actually. It's
That's
pretty
right.
Amazing.
That's why I'm saying.
It's not even a block away.
You probably go all the time.
Not as much as I'd like to admit. I'm sorry.
Uh-oh.
But I should.
You should.
I'll go tomorrow.
It's pilgrimage.
That's right.
Wear green.
That's America.
That's right. So you study music.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so how does that help you as a musician?
Oh, well, in college you get to study theory and, how different chords work with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And by knowing how music works and how songs work and, oh, I really like this part of the song because, I don't know why I like it.
Mm-hmm.
And you kind of learn the bones of music. Mm-hmm. And it's a bit nerdy, which mm-hmm. I do admit, but
well, it's with color palette.
It's a color palette. There you go.
Every
key is a color, and every chord helps. If you have a really nice chord going to another really nice chord, and if
so
you know
how can they contact you?
Okay, well, you can contact
Let's get right down to the shameless promotion. How can they contact you?
Well, you can look me up on Facebook, Michael Maloney.
Is that correct? That email address is your email address?
That is my email address.
Okay.
If you have any questions or would like to call me or get in touch with me.
You stick to the email. And are you on YouTube?
Yeah, I'm on YouTube.
How do they find you on YouTube?
YouTube.com/ Michael, M-I-C-H-A-L, M Music, Michael M Music. And I have a few music videos up there that I've made and some videos from nursing homes.
Okay.
And also MySpace.com/ Michael M Music.
Okay.
As well.
Okay. And do you have a website?
Nothing professional, really, just the MySpace and YouTube and Facebook.
Okay.
Maybe someday.
Do you want to say hi to anybody?
I would like to say
when they're
hi
sitting down. Your mom's going to want to see this.
My mother.
You definitely want to say hi to your mom.
This is a shout out, personalized shout out to Ann Maloney in Medford, and the rest of the Maloney clan in Medford.
Okay. And so are you going to be appearing anyplace? I mean, you're going to be at the Wang Center teaching. You're going to be at UMass Boston doing whatever you do there, creating some sort of pallet or something. Mm-hmm. And did you know a pallet in the south is a bed?
I'm going to write this down.
It
is. Is this on the test?
It is.
Is this on
pallet
the test?
In the south is a bed.
Oh, okay.
And so then you're going to have a future in music and healthcare?
I'm saying music and physical therapy, and so I don't know if which one will work out. I know that I'd love both. With the experience with the older people, I've really enjoy helping people, and music is therapeutic and of its by itself.
Right, the brain and music and chords. And are you appearing anyplace?
I don't know when this is going to air, but I am playing at the Wakefield Care and Rehab Nursing Home on Mother's Day. They have a first floor and a second, and a basement floor. I don't know when this will air, but
a little bit after that, sorry, probably.
If you missed it.
Yeah,
I'm
but
also
you could say hi to them now.
Well, hello to all the patients at the Wakefield Care and Rehab Center. I'll also be there on Father's Day as well.
So what they want you to do is play a song for end credits. Did Jen have anything in mind? Play something folksy.
I could do my award-winning song, The Long and Winding Road to Medford.
Now, play something folksy. Okay. Hurry up.
Okay. The long and winding road to Medford comes from Winchester. If you want to see trees and a toad, drive down South Border Road. You can view the whole city rolling down Route 93. We've got a bad mall. It's one story tall. It's called the Meadow Glen. I cannot remember when it had more than 7 stores. Now it may sound absurd, we're the hometown to Michael Bloomberg. Many times I'd like to see our high school football team win, but they always get defeated by the team from Malden. We've got 8 baseball fields. At rotaries we don't yield to the oncoming cars. We speak like we're from Mars. Go Mefa, go Mefa. And yeah, we've got Tufts University. We've got Maria Menounos. She now lives on the West Coast. Many times I'd like to leave Medford, but something draws me back. Maybe it's all the Dunkin' Donuts we have. We've got over 10 Dunkin' Donuts.
Down at Medford Square, there are barbers who'll cut your hair. We've got houses from the Revolution.